There's this special look that people discuss in terms of a cinematic feeling YouTube video, and in my recent work, I've tried to implement these things into my creative process, specifically in terms of color grading my vlogs to look a little more cinematic. So in this week's video, I wanted to share with you guys how I'd go about editing, but mainly color grading my videos to get that cinematic feeling. And the secret sauce to the cinematic film-like look that I'm trying to recreate today is actually a plugin. Dehancer is a film emulation plugin for pretty much all of your favorite editing softwares. Fortunately for myself, I have been given access to this plugin by the Dehancer team for free for me to go in, play around, test it out, and share this with you guys today. But do not worry, because all the opinions and anything that I say in this video is fully my thoughts. I'm not getting paid to say any of this. This is legitimately how I've been editing my videos for the last little bit. Okay, so here I am in my editing software of choice. This is Adobe Premiere Pro, and I've just created a new project and sequence here with clips from a trip that I took recently to New York. These videos were all shot in S-Log3 on my Sony A6700. So typically what I'll do once it's time to color is first create my adjustment layers, and that's as easy as just going over here, right-clicking, and adding a new item into your project. So you can pretty much add as many or as little adjustment layers as you wish. Some people like to have every little adjustment they make to their video on a different adjustment layer. Me personally, I don't do that. I try to batch a lot of adjustments together on one adjustment layer. So things such as like creative color might be on its own, effects on its own, and basic correction on its own. But I don't really feel the need to split every single little dial up into its own adjustment layer. So the first thing I do when I color grade is convert my log footage into a more normal format, such as Rec. 709. But the fun thing about Dehancer is that it actually does this for you. So if you go over here into your effects tab and just search up Dehancer, you can see it pop up right there under Video Effects Film Emulation Dehancer Pro version 2.1. I'm just gonna go ahead and drag that to my first adjustment layer. As you can see, it instantly has an effect on the image, and that's because there's actually already a film stock being applied. Some of the effects are automatically enabled. Don't worry, you can go in and change those as you like. But for the sake of the video, I'm gonna go ahead and turn off the film stock as well as anything else that's turned on right now. So within the Dehancer control tab, you can actually see this input tab where you can actually go here and choose the camera that you shot on, and it'll automatically convert the log footage that you have into a Rec. 709 profile. Since I'm shooting on my A6700 in S-Log3 S-Gamut 3 Cine, I'm just gonna go here, click that. So with that one click, it automatically converts it from flat log profile into something a little prettier. But now this is where the fun happens, because I can close this tab and actually go into the film tab and choose the film stock that I want. As you can see, there's lots of different film profiles that you can use, from CineStill to Fuji to Kodak. There's also some interesting ones such as Polaroid or Instax film that you can play around with, but no matter what you're looking for, I'm sure they have it. I can then go on to start applying some of these film emulation effects such as compression, grain, halation, bloom, and even print, which is maybe one of the more important ones. Grain is, well, exactly what you think it is. It's grain on your image, and you can select which kind of grain you want, or you can set up a custom profile. But for me, I'm just gonna go with the 35mm ISO 50. It's super subtle, but it's there. Next is halation, which if you don't know, is basically just these kind of fringy red hues and weird color cast in anything that has highlight roll off on it. When I turn it on and off, you can really notice it around the edges of the bridge or the edges of the building or even around the edges of my hair. And it really does a lot to push your footage towards that film emulation cinematic look. And then there's bloom, which basically achieves the same effect as having like a ProMist filter on your lens would do. It blooms the highlights, softens your image to give it a more dreamy look. So just by using Dehancer, I've already converted this image from this flat log look into something very, very usable. I personally would be already okay with exporting this footage as final, but because I do have the time and the tools here, I'm gonna actually take it one step further and add a few more adjustments to these adjustment layers. So moving up one adjustment layer, I'm gonna pop open the Lumetri color tab here to make some more adjustments to the image. So I typically do some basic adjustments here, such as contrast, exposure, to really lock in the style that I'm going for. So in this video, it's actually a super bright image because there's a lot of sky here and it's an overcasty day. So I'm just gonna go ahead and turn down some of the highlights here so you can recover a little bit of detail there in this bridge. That already looks way better. And maybe to go along with it, I'm gonna just bump up the shadows a little bit because down here it was starting to get a little bit muddy. Next, this is where I try to have a lot of fun with it, and this is usually where I'll implement my creative style. Here I'll go a little bit crazy and experiment with some new colors, whether I'm trying to push like a really teal and orange look, or maybe a faded dark green look, or maybe a sad emotional blue look. That's what'll happen on this adjustment layer. You can use any of the tabs here in Premiere or Dehancer to get that creative look you're going for, or commonly what people will do is use an input LUT where you can load in these files that basically just do it for you. But remember that there is no one-click solution to anything, so even when you load in that LUT, it's probably not going to look great and you're going to have to do a little bit of adjusting. Some people kind of hate on people who use LUTs, but me personally, I think it's a great tool. If it saves you time and does what you need it to do, you're kind of dumb if you're not using it. Just make sure you really understand how to color your images, because that LUT is not going to give you the exact image that you want. You're going to have to go into all the tabs that I mentioned today and do some sliding around. I've pretty much just played around with some of the curves here and applied some saturation adjustments to really get the color popping in this red brick here. And finally, this last adjustment layer, which I don't always use, is really just for final adjustments. I'll sit back and take a final look at this image and really just change anything I don't like. So this already looks really good. If I really wanted to spend some time, I could do some masking on my skin tone here because it is getting a little red and the sky here is getting a little too bright, so I could again turn down that highlight. To me, that looks like a pretty well graded image. So with just a few basic adjustments and the help of Dehancer, I've taken this image from a flat log image to this, to this, to this, and finally to this. And the best part is, since all of my tweaks are saved onto these separate adjustment layers, it's as easy as just copy pasting them onto any other clip to really help you maximize your efficiency when color grading. So here I have a shot of me standing on this street corner in New York, kind of near Central Park, with all of these tall buildings in the background. But the process here is the same. I'm going to select my camera to convert it to Rec. 709 to make the image more normal looking. And then I'm going to select the film that I want to use. I've been really enjoying this Kodak Ektar 25. Next, I'm going to do some basic adjustments here, and this image actually looks pretty good to me. Next, my creative color, and then some final adjustments to really lock in that look that I'm going for. And that's basically it. I go from an image looking like this, to this, to this, to this, to this. I'm not saying that I'm a professional colorist at all, I really don't believe that, but I've definitely curated a process that works for me and gets me the images that I like to see. So for anyone like myself from a few years ago who maybe didn't really know how to color grade and use their camera's full potential, here's some tips for you. Number one, like I've been saying, there is no one-click solution. Do not think that by purchasing any LUT or any plugin or anything is gonna give you that perfect image. Number two, don't overdo the effects. I know sometimes it's really easy to see all these cool videos out there and try and copy all these different styles. My thinking when it comes to these effects is that I want my viewers to feel the emotion that I'm putting into it and not visually see it. I want it to be a feeling. And finally, this kind of goes against what I just said, but in a different kind of way, is don't worry about making your videos feel natural. If you wanted your videos to look exactly how they felt when you were there, natural, straight out of camera, all you would really have to do is convert it to Rec. 709, or even easier is just don't even shoot in a profile picture. I try not to worry so much about making my videos feel natural because in reality, life is a little gray and there's not a lot of color out there, especially this time of year in the spring when everything's melting and it's quite gross and gray out there. So don't worry too much if the colors don't look natural. They didn't look that good natural anyways. Put your own creative spin on it and make it your own. So on top of just being a plugin for all of your favorite desktop editing softwares, Dehancer also has an iOS app that edits photos and videos. It has almost all the same tools that you saw me use today, and I mainly use it as a quick way to edit both my Instagram posts and my stories. So if you guys want to check it out for yourself, you can find it on the App Store, as well as for the full desktop experience, you can find it at the first link in my description. And if you want to save a little bit of money when purchasing the desktop plugin, you can use the code on screen right now during checkout. So thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you to the Dehancer team, and I hope you're able to get something out of this editing session to go and make your own videos more cinematic.